One day I didn't bring my sunglasses. I may need them, Francis. I'll be all right, at least for now. We've got a couple more folks coming on in. We'll let them gather up, and then we'll get started. I appreciate you all coming out. This is our sixth house dedication, and it's very exciting to be a part of this. We've got others that are being built now. We look forward to helping out with those and being a part of that service. But this is a very special occasion as we come to worship, to relax and rest and be thankful for God's leadership and guidance and protection through all this work that we've been doing. And we also want to thank some people. But I want to begin with a word of prayer. I'm going to ask Allison, one of our deacons, to come up, and she's going to lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this time to come together, Lord, for the dedication of this home. Lord, just another proof that from great tragedy you can really bring a blessing, and we thank you so much. Lord, we thank you for each one that had a part in making this home possible. Lord, there are so many, and we just ask a special blessing on each one of them, and we pray that you'd be with Karen and Tim and Jessica and Josh as they start a new life in their new home, that they would just truly dedicate their lives to you, Lord, and we'll just have a wonderful life here in this home. In Jesus' name, amen.
Our brother Roy, our minister of music, is going to lead us in some music here.
What a glorious day. So good to see you. Tonight just overflowed from worship this morning. What a morning of worship we had this morning. Wasn't God, he was just all over this place. And thank you so much for being here. We're just going to sing a few choruses, and I've got them wrote down right here, so I got the words right here. They are, if y'all can see from here. Yeah, I can't even see. That's a good thing. We'll start off Only Believe, and we'll just go from there, okay? Only believe. Only believe, all things are possible. Only believe, only believe, only believe, all things are possible. Only believe. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. He got the whole world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. He got that whole world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. He got you and me in his hand. He got you and me in his hand. He got you and me in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. He got the Newton family in his hand. He got the Newton family in his hand. He got the Newton family in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. Come on now. He got the whole world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. He got that whole wide world in his hand. He got the whole world in his hand. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. Thank you. God bless you.
Very good. Thank you. I've already learned I'm not going to be able to look over at Karen too much because we're going both of us will be crying here in a minute. We've got a lot of folks here, special guests, and I wanted to recognize a couple here to start with, and we'll ask them to come up and say a few words. First of all, very much appreciate the work that Congressman Mike Rogers' office provided us and the congressman, especially in the days when we were just trying to figure out how we could help people and dealing with agencies and all these groups that came in here to help us assist in the recovery from the disaster. So graciously, Congressman Rogers is here. We appreciate your time. Ask you to come forward and say a few words to us, and we wanted to thank you personally for all your good help in your office in our time of need. Thank you for being here.
Thank you all very much for inviting me. This is just a really, really neat event, mainly because when I look out here, I'm reminded of what's great about Alabama and America. I look around this crowd, and it reminds me how proud I am that I represent Alabama. Y'all are the salt of the earth, and this is just a wonderful example of what made this country and this state so great. I listened to Allison's prayer, and it reminds me of what I've thought about this whole ordeal. You know, I represent 13 counties, and I had Calhoun and Cherokee affected, and then Tallapoosa County, and altogether 13 people killed and 1,000 displaced. But what we found in the immediate days after the tornadoes was at every location, whether it was here or in any other part of the state, every location had more volunteers than they had tasks that could be done. And that just speaks volumes about your character and about your commitment to your neighbor and your community, and you're to be applauded. And I hope that everybody remembers that. You know, the fact is, in my 53 years, I found that in every bad thing that happens, and I mean every bad thing, there's, as Allison said in the prayer, there's a blessing that comes out of it, or as I refer to it, a silver lining that you learn something. And the silver lining in this disaster was we are just very blessed to live in the United States of America and have such wonderful neighbors and people that care about us around us. So I hope all of you take note of the fact that you are to be patted on the back yourself for caring and being such a part of this family's life. And I'm proud of you, and I'm proud of you letting me be a part of this event, and congratulations.
Okay, we also have a representative from National Cooperative Baptist Fellowship, the CBF, and most of you know we've been able to do this because of partnerships with all kinds of groups, businesses, individuals, and churches from all different denominations and even faiths. And I'm very proud that God's people have come together to do this kind of work. But our primary missions partner at Williams has been the Cooperative Baptist Fellowship for several years, and CBF churches have been the ones who have primarily helped us to be able to do the things that we've been doing. So I'm happy that Harry Rowland is here, the missional specialist from CBF, to share a few words of encouragement with us. Thank you for being here, Harry.
It is a joy to be here with you on a day that is a blessing. As I talked with Tim and Karen, I don't know how many times I count the word you use, blessing, as we just visited over there. And so certainly there's a tenderness about this day, but also a rich day of blessing. I know from CBF and from the churches that have been involved here. In fact, I'm a part of First Baptist Rome, who's been down here working alongside you as well. That's my home church. But even though I don't get to be there all that often, 3 weeks ago I was in Haiti. We're building 1,000 homes down there after the earthquake. And then I was in South Africa 2 weeks ago and D.C. this last week as we continue to work as far as working, responding to disasters and people who are living in difficult times. But when I got the invitation to be here, I said there's no place I'd rather be than right here to actually be with those who are working and making it happen. Sometimes I'm at about 30,000 feet working on some of those endeavors and don't have the chance to just stand and be right here with you. But this is a true joy for me. As I gather and think about this, I'm certainly reminded of what Scripture tells us in James chapter 1. The writer reminds us what pure religion's all about. And he says pure religion is taking care of the orphans, the widows, the aliens, especially in their time of distress. You know, so often our world defines goodness by what you do and what you don't do. And you're good if you don't do this or you do that. And that's maybe a humanistic type of definition of goodness. Scripture defines goodness as living in grace. And so as you live in grace and practice grace, then Scripture declares you good. And while you stand here today on this front porch is an act of grace. And because of this, God's church will be uplifted. I would just share one story that I enjoy, and I don't want to take too long. One of my favorite pastors is an African-American pastor named Reverend Manuel Scott. I like being with African-American pastors because I get be called Reverend Doctor, you know, something like that. You know, they keep adding to your name in there. But he turned to me and said, Reverend Doctor Roland, he said, do you know the difference between us African-American preachers and you white preachers? We were at a preaching conference in New Mexico a number of years ago. And I thought I could say something, but it was safer just to say I didn't know. So I said I didn't know. And he said, well, you know, he says, we both have God's revelation, and we both have inspiration, and we both have the Holy Spirit's illumination. But he says, we have imagination. And he rolled his eyes. And then tragically, he preached first, and I had to follow him, which was a great mistake. But as he preached his sermon, he began by shouting out, and he said, I love church. Will you say it with me? I love church. Say it again. I love church. And he went on, he told a story. He told a story about growing up as a rural migrant worker on the cotton fields of Arkansas, one of seven children. And they were very poor and didn't have much at all. In fact, they didn't have the opportunity to have much dessert or dessert at all, except maybe on someone's birthday. And when it came around for a birthday and someone was going to have a cake, his mom would go to the store. At that time, you used to buy this stuff called scratch. I don't think you can buy it anymore. We used to make stuff out of something called scratch. But you'd go buy it, and you mix it up together, and you make cakes and things out of that. So anyhow, she went to the store and bought a bunch of scratch, and she came back, and she put it together, and she was making the cake. Well, she didn't, they were quite poor, and they didn't have enough money that if the cake did not turn out properly just to start again. So she baked what the Reverend Dr. Manuel Scott called a test cake. It's like a little cupcake, the way sat there described it. And she would put the batter in that, and she would bake that. And then she would test it, you know, to make sure it tasted properly, make sure it rose the way it's supposed to rise before she baked the whole cake. And I guess if it didn't, you add more scratch to it and stir it up some more, whatever you need to do. But anyhow, after she had done that, Manuel Scott said, what do you think happened to that little test cake after she had tested it? Whichever one of those seven kids was nearest got to finish it off in the kitchen. You know, she kind of handed the rest of that little cake. Then she did what she needed. And Dr. Scott said, do you think that test cake satisfied our appetite? He said, no. He said, all that test cake did was build a sense of anticipation, expectation to that big cake that'd be on the table at that birthday. Maybe three or four layers with icing and candles. They didn't satisfy, but it built a sense of expectation of what was going to happen with that big cake. And then he said, you know what church is? When church is done well, it's like that test cake. It gives us a taste of heaven. It's not heaven itself. It gives us a taste of something called hope and love and joy and peace and community. It's like that test cake. Doesn't satisfy us, but gives us a taste of what heaven will be like. First Baptist Williams and the other churches have been a part of this, are like that test cake. It's given this community, this state, this country, this world a taste of heaven. And so Manuel Scott's right. He said he loves church because it's actually church is a taste of heaven. I love church. Let's say it again. I love church. God bless you for what you've done here today.
Thank you, Reverend Dr. Harry Rowland. They don't call me that here either, so I just, that's right. As always, when we do these, we have a lot of folks we want to recognize, and Tyler is going to come in a few minutes and lead us in that, but I wanted to be sure that you all know how much you're appreciated. People all the time ask, how can you do this? How's this happening? How's it sustained? And really, when it comes down to it, the Lord is doing this. We're always, it's always good for us to remember to be thankful and to remember that God's behind all this. I think all of us here at our church know that without the Lord's leadership and calling, this couldn't have happened at all. None of us planned it and prepared for it and knew this was going to happen a few months ago, but God has led us through this, and I think it's really important that we always pause to remember that. Also, God has led us people who are willing to serve and take time, and most of you here have done that. Many of our folks who are not able to be here have done that, and you've prayed, And I just wanted you to know how proud I am to be your pastor, to be part of this church, how proud I am of you and all of your dedication. You see a need, and you have compassion. God puts that in your heart, and you act on that compassion. And that really is what makes a church. And so I'm really proud of you, and thank you so much for that. I want to recognize just a few groups here. Tyler's going to really do most of that. But our decorators, if you would just raise your hands, all the folks who are part of the decorating of this house. We fully furnish the houses. Raise them high. We want to thank you. Y'all have done a great job. And we're going to do something a little different tonight. The Newtons have not been inside this house yet to see it all decorated. And that's why they were standing way over there, because Karen said, if I'm any closer, I'll be tempted just to break on in the house and see it. So what we're going to do in a few minutes is we're going to let the decorators go in, and Tyler as well, with the Newtons for the first time. We're going to stay in the yard just for a minute and let them go in and see their home for the first time, fully furnished and ready. And then when y'all are ready to welcome everybody else in, and I hope that won't be long, just open the door and welcome everybody into your home. The cleaning crew, our cleaning crew, that's hard work, and it's tedious and often overlooked, and I appreciate all the cleaning crew. So if you're on the cleaning crew, raise your hand. All right, good. Very good. Thank y'all so much. Thank you. I keep waiting for y'all to come over to my house and clean up, but anyway. Furniture movers, some of these folks won't be sure to recognize Nick Bonds. Where's Nick? There he is, Nick Bonds, Alex. Alex, I just love that. I love the story because of you guys and the way God's worked in your lives through this whole experience. And you know Nick coming and being part of our church for a while and through this experience accepting Christ and being baptized. And we're so proud, Nick, that you're part of our church. Alex coming here with his youth group earlier this summer and deciding to move down here and go to Jacksonville State University and really has become part of our congregation. We're so proud of you two young men. And we appreciate all this time and effort that you've given to work on this house and get the furniture moved. And I know that's a little hard work sometimes, and I know that you've worked hard doing that because you love this and you want to make a difference, and you are, and I want you to know that. And Shane Harrelson, I wanted to recognize him. I'm not sure Shane's here or not, and I can't see much besides Rex right there, so... is Shane here? Shane Harrelson, when you get a chance to see Shane and Chastity, they've worked so hard in many, many different ways, and they're not going to wave a flag or shout about what they do. They're sort of quiet. But, boy, he's been very dedicated and helpful in all the work that we've been doing. And it just says Duncan right here. I guess that's Mike Duncan. As always, we appreciate Mike Duncan. And we have some others we want to recognize as well. I think at this point I wanted to recognize one of the churches that really worked a lot on this house, and they love this area, and they love what we're doing, and they felt the Lord's leadership to come, not once, but now a second time, the folks from Highland Hills Baptist Church in Macon, Georgia. Wave your hand so we can see you. Thank you. And we love y'all, and we really do appreciate everything that you have done. And they said, let us know when this house is ready. We want to be there for the dedication. And I think they got home and blinked, and it was ready. So they've just come right back, and we do appreciate that. One couple, I think y'all were in Florida and drove all the way up here so you could get here again. Neil Heath is with this church, and I think y'all have a presentation or something. Do you want to do that now? Okay, well, come on, and we'll let you do that.
On our first trip up a few weeks ago, at the end of August, we came for a dedication, and we saw that the family was presented a tree for their yard, and the folks who were here said, we'd like to do that for the house that we worked on and the family that we got to know. And so we didn't dig a hole already for you to trip and fall in. We will let Tim and Karen figure out exactly where they'd like to put their tree. But we did want to add something to decorate the outside since it's already so beautiful inside. And thanks for letting us come back. Amen.
And you all know that a house can't be built without someone directing the work. And we've been so blessed, haven't we, to have builders in our congregation. And you all know from years of experience that they have given of their time and skill and expertise to help build these houses. They helped us from building our church, mission trips, all kinds of things through the years. They have a great heart for God. And all of these builders have done such a wonderful job of giving of themselves and their time and leadership to be able to get these houses going and built. And they've taken such pride in the work. They're building their own houses in respect. And one of those is the builder who was the lead contractor over this house, Tyler Ponder. And Tyler, I'm going to ask you to come and say whatever you'd like to say today. Tyler, we thank you for your time and care on this house.
Bad, y'all put Sharonda and Patsy right in the line of sight. Cause when I retire from home building, I'm going to be a professional crier with them. So I'll try not to. But I would like to thank some people. I did write that down. I don't write anything else down because it's going to come from the heart whenever I say anything. But Donnie Glass did all the masonry. And I've been doing this for 27 years. Patsy and Allison and Donna is the best-looking framing crew I've ever had. Ed Upton, Sean Ponder, Riley Green. That was a miracle in itself. When we got started on this house, Riley, which notoriously sleeps late, he said, I'm going to go out there and help with Jika's house. And for that couple of weeks, he actually was at the store at 5:30 in the morning. He has reverted to his old ways since then. We won't go there. Bo and Ty Green really helped out a lot. Webb Concrete was really good with materials. Beaver Payne, especially, one of their salesmen. Buddy McLeod donated all the material for this, and John and the electrical crew from the church. Dwayne Bass, another blessing from this. Got all of our plumbing stuff donated from Toto, Blake Shue, and Blake won't take a lot of credit, but he's building his house back right now, but he's donated all of his sheetrock labor for everything we've done, not just this one, all of them. And Mike's already talked about the Highland Hill bunch, but I want to thank them too. Neil was... I didn't have to do much with the paint, and he just said, what do you want us to do? Get us some stuff here, and we'll take care of it. And they did, and did a great job. I want to thank y'all. Don Jones and Arlen Rozelle from Quality Gutter donated the gutters, and Don came and helped with the siding. Chris Davenport from Valley Heating and Cooling, he donated the units from Train and all of his time on this. And Jim Fair donated all the grading out here. And also would like to thank Tim and Karen. And building's easy when you got people like them. They're just appreciative. And they just said, we trust you. Do what you want to do. And I want to thank you. I was over here early this morning, and I'm going to steal some of Mike's thunder. And some scripture came to me. In chapter 2 in Acts, the early church. And all the believers were together and had everything in common, selling their possessions and goods. They gave to anyone as he had need. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those were being saved. I didn't know Tim and Kieran. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention something. I pulled in the driveway next door many times. And let's continue to keep the lips in our prayers. There's a lot of good things happening, and a lot of stuff's going on, but there still hurts. And let's just keep them there. And on closing, I'd just like to say from April 27th that I want to thank Jesus for the revival in our church and our communities. You know, thank you.
He came up early a while ago when we were standing over there, and he said he had his Bible with him, and he said, "Now, what are you going to read for Scripture?" And I said, "Acts chapter 2, verses 40." And you know, and I pray and think a lot seriously about each passage I read for the families where we go, and we've said God's in this today. It's just really amazing, and you know, you did a pretty good job. So I'm going to remember that next time I ask you to get up and do something. You say, "I can't speak." Thank you, Tyler, and I appreciate the love and care you've given to this family and to this project. At this time, I want to invite, Tim and Karen have a guitar up here, and I thought, well, maybe they're just going to sit up here and pick and grin and sing a little bit. But really, Riley Green is going to. Riley's going to come and lead us in some songs here. Riley, I appreciate you, and thank you for coming and being willing to lead us in some good music tonight.
April 27, it was on a Wednesday night. Worst storms I'd ever seen tore through this countryside. There was devastation all throughout the South. In times as tough as these, you know it's so easy to doubt. A man can't help but wonder why. The sun came up that very next day, I could see God's light. Tuscaloosa, he was calming people down. And up in Jacksonville, he was in my hometown. Down in Birmingham, was pulling survivors from the rubble. At the very first sign of trouble, I know it seems dark, but wait till the storm's clear. You see that God was in Bama this year. Wendell's house got blown away, he was still inside. He's a true believer, knows he's lucky to be alive. Uncle Ty's whole porch was gone, so was he. He felt it best to start clean up just down the street. People drove for miles around just to lend a helping hand. Some of them I'd never seen before, but now I'll call them friends. Just amazes me how we can all come together. God's filled this country with Southern pride. It's stronger than anywhere. In Tuscaloosa, he was calling people down. And up in Jacksonville, that's where he was in my hometown. And down in Birmingham, pulling survivors from the rubble. He'll always show up at the very first sign of trouble. Well, I know it seems dark, but wait till the storm's clear. You see that God was in Bama this year. Felt like he rode in on a wave of crimson tide. I saw God's railway to heaven. He was whistling Dixie all down the line. Thank you.
Mike Rogers, you might want to take him up to Washington and let him know a little bit about Alabama. Like, that'd be good. Good. And I appreciated your words. We've talked a lot about Alabama and neighbors through all of this and how people have come together and throughout the South, and we really do appreciate that a lot. Thank you for what you said. Just a couple other folks I wanted to recognize real quick, and then we're going to present some gifts to y'all and let you come in and see your house. It's very important to remember that there are people who are working behind the scenes all the time that we don't see. And everybody's got to go to work, school, whatever, and you might not realize this, but Steve Green has helped a lot throughout this whole process, and I think he's out here somewhere, right there. Steve, we appreciate you and all you've done. Thank you so much for all your time and effort that you've given. Bill Prickett and Deb English and a whole bunch of folks who've helped us with cooking. We've got people coming in that we're hosting at our church, and we're providing them meals and hospitality, and I really do appreciate all the time and effort they give. And it's very hard to give that time, and I know that they're doing it out of love, but I really do hope that you'll get a chance. When you see them, there's Bill and Deb and others, if you'll see them, just pat them on the back and thank them for all the time and dedication that they're giving. And I really enjoyed the Wednesday night suppers, by the way. I'm glad we're starting those back. That's one of the good things God brought out of this time. And I would be remiss not to remember, and he gets on to me every time, but really, honestly, Wallace Amarode is there every day, every day. And we absolutely could not move forward if it weren't for Wallace. And he's got a cell phone in one ear, and now he's got his little office set up in that hallway. And he's got a phone in the other ear, and he's working them. And he's just a great representative for our church to people, and I really do appreciate all he's doing. I just want to say, sort of in closing my part here, when I thought about that passage for y'all, that's a great, what we used to call an idealistic view of the church from the early church, Acts chapter 2. Tyler read it for us. But I think a lot of us are seeing that as a reality. That's not just something for the past or for the days of the Bible. That's a reality that can still happen in local churches all around the world. And it still does happen. God is still alive, still working, and people's hearts are still being inspired, and they're serving and making tremendous difference. And this home and this house, as you go in and out every day, Josh and Jessica, as y'all come here, I hope you'll remember, and I know you will, that this is a house the Lord has built. This is through God's people, and it's all been a joint effort. And this is really what church is about. It's about people coming together, trying to help each other out. And we have been so blessed to get to know you two better. I'm going to have to look away because, Karen, you're going to make me cry. But but y'all are amazing people. And y'all have given so much time working here. You've been dedicated and coming to church and being involved. And you're such an inspiration to us. And I know you always come up and say, thank you, thank you, thank you. And I know that that's genuine gratitude from y'all. But I want to say to you two and to your family, Tim and Karen, thank you, thank you, thank you. Y'all are wonderful lights of Christ for us, and I'm so proud to know you and proud that we're able to be partners in this. And y'all are church. You are church, and this is your family. And I'm so happy that we could be here standing here tonight. And I just want you to remember that. And if anybody ever asks you about the church and they say, is it relevant again, then you say, yes, the church is relevant. The church matters. The churches have come together and shown their mettle, their desire, and their calling. And I'm proud that we are a part of God's people called the church. So at this time, we'll ask y'all two to come on up. We got some gifts and things we want to present to you. Jessica, Josh. First of all, we've got one of the 911 signs, 74 Dove Welch Road. We hope that you never have to use this other than when we say, where is that house? It's out there. So I'm gonna let you all in. Really, y'all should present this. This is a cookbook from where? Highland Hills Baptist Church. Okay. They left these cookbooks and said, every time we dedicate a house, would y'all give a cookbook out? And we've been doing that. So I don't know who gets it. Okay. You get that one. And I've got some crosses in here that was made from one of the members of our church. Each of you can get one. Little crocheted crosses, uses a bookmark or whatever you like. And, of course, these little communion cups, and I hope that y'all, I think y'all probably have some, but this was one you might just want to set out. No, I want one. You want one? All right, you got it. And I got a few more of those left, but, that, of course, that's from Israel, and those olive wood cups, and it's part of the communion that we feel with God, but also with you as part of our church family and our neighbors. So we love you, appreciate you a lot. And I always forget this part, but these blankets or quilts that we have here. And this is from, I think these are from Iowa. No, these are from Florida. There's two quilting groups that have provided some quilts for y'all. This is from Bradenton, Florida, from a group. And it's just a beautiful quilt, and there's a lot more to it. I'm not going to unfold the whole thing, but you can see that. And I hope y'all will enjoy that. And remember the many other folks from around the country that are praying for y'all and continue to care a lot about you. So I'm going to set this back over here. And there's one more that goes with it. You see it. And then the last thing, we present a Bible to everyone that we dedicate. And this is scribed the Newtons on the front. And inside says, presented to Tim and Karen Newton by First Baptist Church of Williams on October 2nd, 2011. So here's a Bible for you home. God bless y'all very much. I think you might want to say a few words. I'm not sure. But, Tim, you want to say anything, you're welcome to do that. Okay.
You want to swap places with
him? You have to forgive me. I'm not much of a speech maker. However, some of you talked to me before say I run at the mouth too much. But you probably heard the terminology, you know, it hasn't hit me yet. Well, today it did. I really don't have any words that would justify the experiences that we've felt, not from the storm, but from everybody and their help, and their thoughts and prayers and their gifts. No words can mention it. One person personally I do want to thank, and like I was telling Mike earlier, he's the second best carpenter I know. And I believe you know who the first best one is. And Tyler, thank you so very much. Williams First Baptist Church has changed our lives along with several other people. I can't go into each individual people that's helped in the groups. It's just astronomically so much. We feel so blessed the fact that not only we actually didn't receive just one home, we've received two. This home here at 74 and our new home at Williams First Baptist Church. And if I say any more, I'm going to cry. So thank you very much for everything.
At this time, our tradition is to have you all get, you know, families get in the yard here. We're going to circle you and just have a time of blessing. And then after that, we'll let you come in and see the home. You want to sit that down here? So if y'all just try to get around this family here somehow, and then we'll have our blessing and our prayer.
Stretching right. Everybody this way.
And we'll sort of say it's a circle, but we all know. Yeah, yard's not big enough. So what we've been doing, and I like to do, if you would just take a few moments and notice this four right here in the yard. This is their home, their place. And with God's help, they have a nice, brand new, wonderful house to live in. And I would like for you, just in a time of silence, to lift up a prayer on their behalf to God for whatever you feel led to pray for them, for happiness, health, protection, guidance, for wisdom, for a sense of God in their home. Whatever you'd like to say, this is what we'll do tonight. And just in a few moments, we'll do that. And then Brother Roy is going to lead us in a song. And after that song, if you would, our decorators and Tyler, y'all go on inside, and then we'll let the Newtons go in to see their home for the first time tonight. All right, let's bow as we pray. Thank you. Amen. All right, would our decorators come on forward? And Tyler, y'all come on. You want everybody to go around the side. Would you go around the side door, they said. And Tim and Karen, y'all follow them, and then when y'all are ready, just let us know. Won't y'all come in the front door? I think that'd be nice. Yeah.
I forgot to tell them.
Well, tell everybody that we got Tyler gift. We'll give it to
him. Well,
no,
I only forgot to tell more important, Wallace's new work.
Oh, yeah. What is it?
Are y'all going in the
yard? I don't know.
I'm supposed to stand here.
Where's Josh?
Oh, okay. I'm in the porch. Well, the porch.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
They're gonna take a picture. You need to get a picture made with them. You need to get a picture made with them. You want to come in and look? Okay. When they look, you come in when they start going through.